Welcome students, today we are going to start very interesting chapter of science, that is acids, bases and salts. You have already studied in lower standard about acids and bases, that what are acids and what are bases. Here we are going to study about this acids and base, along with that we are going to study about salts also in detail. So first of all let us start with the basics which you have studied in lower classes. So students, you know that acids are substances which are sour in taste. In day-to-day life, we come across many such things that contains acids. For example, citrus fruits, milk, apple, vinegar, etc. You also know that substances which are bitter in taste are called bases. Here are some of the examples of the bases which we are using in our daily life. Soap, household cleaners, antacids, etc. contains base. Let us study about acids in detail. Acids are the substances which have sour taste. They turn blue litmus solution red. Litmus solution or litmus paper are the indicators with the help of which we can identify whether the given substance is an acid or a base. Third one. They give H plus ion in the aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means the solution of acid containing water. So when acids react with water, H plus ion is produced. This we are going to study in chemical properties of acids in the next topic. The term acid has been derived from Latin word acidus, which means sour. Here are some of the examples of acids. Some are weak acids and some are strong acids. Strong acids are HCl, hydrochloric acid, H2SO4, sulfuric acid, HNO3, nitric acid. Weak acids are CH3COOH, that is acetic acid, oxalic acid and lactic acid. Now what is a concentrated acid? If the acid is having more amount of acid and less amount of water in it, then that acid is called concentrated acid. And if the acid is having more amount of water and very less amount of acid, then it is called dilute acid. So in the dilute acid, proportion of water is more, and in a concentrated acid, proportion of acid is more. Now next is bases. These are the substances which are bitter in taste and soapy in touch. They turn red litmus solution blue. So when bases are added to red litmus solution, the solution will turn blue. They give OH minus ion in its aqueous solution. That is, the reaction of bases with water will give OH minus ion. Examples of bases are strong bases, NaOH, sodium hydroxide, KOH, potassium hydroxide, CaOH twice, calcium hydroxide. Weak bases, NH4OH, ammonium hydroxide. Alkalis, they are the bases which are soluble in water. So the bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis, and the examples are sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, etc. Now what are salts? Salts are the compounds which are formed by reaction of acid and base. So when acid and base react with each other, the compound which is formed is called salt. We are going to study in detail about salts as we further move towards the chapter ahead. Now students, let us study about indicators. First of all, what are indicators? Indicators are those substances which tells us whether a substance is acidic or basic by change in color, smell, etc. So if a substance is given to us and we are not knowing whether it is an acid or a base, then with the help of indicator we can find it. How we will be able to find it? When we will add this indicator to the substance, either there will be change in color or change in smell or any other change will happen, with the help of which we will be able to identify whether the substance is acid or base. The example of indicator is litmus solution. Now the indicators are of three types: olfactory indicators, natural indicators and synthetic indicators. Olfactory indicators. Those substances whose odor changes in acidic or basic media are called olfactory indicators. Means the substances whose smell will change when acid or base is added to it are called olfactory indicators. The example of olfactory indicators are clove, vanilla, onion, etc. Next is natural indicators. Turmeric, litmus obtained from lichen, etc. are natural indicators. Students, you might have observed that a stain of curry on white cloth becomes reddish brown when soap, which is basic in nature, is scrubbed on it. This is one of the example of color change. You can see here that yellow color of turmeric is getting changed into reddish brown when bees is added to it. Next is synthetic indicators. Methyl orange, phenolphthalein, etc. are synthetic indicators. Now students, let us see the effect of indicators in acids and bases. First one is red litmus. It remains red in acids and turns blue in base. So if you are having this solution and if you are dipping red litmus paper in it, and if it is remaining red, then the solution is acidic, and if it is turning blue, then the solution is basic. Next is blue litmus. It turns red in acids and remains blue in basic. Next is phenolphthalein. It becomes colorless in acids. It is violet in color, and an acid is added to this phenolphthalein solution, it becomes colorless. And if base is added to this phenolphthalein solution, its color becomes pink. Next is methyl orange. It is orange in color. In presence of acid, it turns red. And if base is there, then it turns yellow. So with the help of these indicators, you can identify whether the substance is acid or base. Now students, let us study the chemical properties of acid. First is reaction of acid with metal. When acid reacts with metal, the metal displaces hydrogen from the acid and hydrogen gas is formed. And the metal combines with remaining part of acid and a compound called salt is formed. So, acid plus metal will give salt plus hydrogen gas. Here in the example you can see hydrochloric acid is reacting with zinc metal. Zinc chloride is formed and hydrogen gas is liberated. Here you can see that zinc is displacing hydrogen from hydrochloric acid and hydrogen gas is formed. And then zinc is reacting with chloride and zinc chloride is formed. Next is reaction of acid with metal carbonate. When acid reacts with metal carbonate, carbon dioxide gas is liberated and salt and water are formed. For example, when hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium carbonate, sodium chloride, that is NaCl, is formed. Along with that, water and carbon dioxide is also formed. Next is reaction with metal hydrogen carbonate. When acid reacts with metal hydrogen carbonate, salt, carbon dioxide and water is formed. So acid plus metal hydrogen carbonate will give you salt, carbon dioxide and water. For example, when hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydrogen carbonate, sodium chloride, water and carbon dioxide is formed. Another property of acid is reaction with metallic oxide. When acid reacts with metal oxide, salt and water are formed. For example, when hydrochloric acid reacts with copper oxide, copper chloride and water is formed. So, these were the chemical properties of acids. Now, let us see the properties of base. When base reacts with metal, salt of the metal is formed and along with this hydrogen gas is liberated. So, base plus metal will give salt plus hydrogen. For example, when sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc, sodium zincate is formed and along with that hydrogen gas is liberated. This reaction is possible only with reactive metals like sodium and potassium. So, it is not possible with less reactive metals. Another property is reaction with non-metallic oxide. When base reacts with non-metallic oxide, salt and water is formed. Calcium hydroxide, which is a base, when reacts with carbon dioxide, that is non-metallic oxide, calcium carbonate, that is salt, is formed. Along with that, water is also formed. So, this is the example of reaction of base with non-metallic oxide. Now, students, we are going to study very important property of acids and bases. That is, what happens when acids and base reacts with water? In presence of water, H plus ion is liberated from HCl molecule. And this separation of H plus ion from HCl molecule cannot occur in absence of water. So, when HCl reacts with water, H plus ion is getting separated from HCl. Here in the example, you can see that when hydrochloric acid reacts with water, hydronium ion, that is H3O plus, is formed, and along with that chloride ion Cl minus ion is also formed. Actually, here what happens when HCl reacts with water, H plus ion is getting separated from HCl. But this H plus ion, that is hydrogen ion, cannot exist alone. So it will react with water and it will form H3O plus ion, which is also called hydronium ion. So H plus ion and reacts with water, that is H2O, H3O plus ion is formed. So, we have seen that acids give H3O plus, that is hydronium ion, or H plus ion, that is in aqueous solution. In water. Now, let us see what happens when a base is dissolved in water. Consider the example of sodium hydroxide, which is a base. When it is dissolved in water, sodium ion, that is Na plus ion, is formed. Along with that, OH minus ion, that is hydroxide ion, consider is another formed. Example, potassium hydroxide. When it reacts with water, potassium ion, that is K plus, and OH minus ion, that is hydroxide ion, is formed. Similarly, with magnesium hydroxide reacting with water, magnesium ion, that is Mg plus 2, is formed. Along with that, 2OH minus, that is hydroxide ion, is formed. From all these examples, it is clear that when bases reacts with water, they generate hydroxide ion, that is OH minus ion. Bases which are soluble in water, they are called alkalis. We have already studied it earlier. So students, this is very important thing you have to keep in mind, that when acids react with water, H3O plus ion or H plus ion is formed, and when bases react with water, OH minus ion is formed. So acids in water produces H plus ion when dissolved in water. H plus ion cannot exist alone. They combine with water molecule to form H3O plus ion. It conducts electricity. Decrease in H3O plus ion concentration per unit volume results in the formation of dilute acid. So, if concentration of H3O plus ion decreases, then the acid is dilute acid. It is highly exothermic reaction. Students, you know what is exothermic reaction. It is a reaction in which large amount of energy is released. So, acids when dissolved in water release large amount of energy. If water is added to concentrated acid, then the heat generated may cause the mixture to splash out and causes burns. Hence, to avoid burns, acid must be added drop-wise into water with constant stirring so that the heat generated spreads over in water. So, while using concentrated acid, this you have to keep in mind. Next is bases in water. Bases produces OH minus ions when dissolved in water. Bases soluble in water are called alkalis. It conducts electricity. Decrease in OH minus ion concentration per unit volume results in the formation of dilute bases. So, if concentration of OH minus ion decreases, then the solution is dilute, or you can say base is dilute base. It is exothermic reaction, which means that during the reaction energy is released. To make basic solution, base must be added drop wise into water with constant stirring so that the heat generated spreads over in water. Students, we studied properties of acids and bases. Now let us see what happens when acid reacts with base. When acid reacts with base, salt and water is formed, and this reaction is called neutralization reaction. So what is neutralization reaction? The reaction in which an acid and a base produces ionic compound, which is called salt and water, is called neutralization reaction. So, acid plus base gives salt plus water. HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, KOH, that is potassium hydroxide, which is a base, gives KCl, that is potassium chloride, and water, H2O. So, students, here you can see it is double displacement reaction. We have already studied what is double displacement reaction in chapter 1. So, students, in this lecture, we studied what are acids, what are bases, we studied properties of acids and bases, we studied what happens when acid reacts with water and when base reacts with water. And in the end, we studied what is neutralization reaction. So with this, we conclude our lecture. We'll continue with other topics in the next lecture.